Hey, Scotty from SBL, and today we are going to be delving into the 10 worst bass tones of all time in amazing songs as voted by you. I put up a poll to ask you guys what you thought were the worst bass tones of all time, and this is the list that you came up with, and it's controversial. James Jamerson, Flea, Chaco Pastorius, what? I'm going to be telling you what I think of each of these bass tones as we go through this video. So let me know if you agree in the comments below. Number one, is it objectively a bad bass tone? Number two, does it work great in the mix? And number three, have you got any bass tones that you'd like to, well, vote for and get on this list? Now, with that said, let's jump in. Now, first up, and definitely one of the most popular ones that you guys voted for, was Jason Newsted on the album And Justice For All. And this is actually the track And Justice For All. First of all, let's listen to a little snippet of the original track. Here we go. There's almost no bass on that track, right? It's just pretty much not there. So first of all, let's find out why it's not there. There's a whole story behind that. And then I'm going to play you the isolated bass track of Jason Newsted on this album. And I think that you'll be surprised to hear the bass tone.
And he goes, okay, now the bass. And I said, great part. All right, I want you to drop the bass level down in the mix where you barely audibly can hear it. I thought it was a joke. So I did that. And then for this, I said, all right, drop it down another 6 to 8 dB. I looked at Hetfield like this. I said, is this guy serious?
Now that was Steve Thompson, the mix engineer on the actual album, talking about his frustration with Lars. But the bass, what did that actually sound like? Well, it sounded like this, and it sounds killing. So it's not that it's a bad bass tone. It's just the bass tone was never there. So next up is Ross Valerie of Journey, and the track is Don't Stop Believing. First of all, we're going to listen to the track just for a few seconds, get a vibe, and then we're going to listen to the bass line isolated so we can see what it really sounded like without the track. Here we go. I dig it. You can hear it with a pick. It's got like a ton of chorus on it. You're probably not gonna turn up to a gig and use that bass sound. Objectively, it's a bad sound. I would just say like it's really unique, but for me, I think it works well really great in this track. Let me know what you think in the comments. I'm gonna say this is still great. Okay, next up is Flea. The track is All Around the World by the Chili Peppers. A lot of you said that this was the worst bass tone that you ever heard. So let's check it out and see what you think. Oh, I know what you guys mean. I know what you guys mean, but it's just like, I think it suits the track really well. For me, is this a bad bass tone? Like, for anything other than this track, probably yes. I think that it's an artistic choice, and I will say that when it gets into the verse, the bass tone is killing. Check this out. All around the world, we can make time, rub a nano stop it, cause I'm in my... Like, that's a killing bass tone. Completely different to the intro. So I love this bass tone. Okay, so next up is definitely going to be a little controversial. It is Verdeen White, the track September with the band Earth, Wind and Fire. In the track it sounds great, right? So it's not, for me, it's not a bad bass tone. I think it's, can you hear the clipping? I think that what's happening there is the strings are hitting the pole pieces of the bass. I think that's that clack. So I wouldn't say it's a bad bass tone, but it's definitely got issues with that clacking on the pickups. Next up is Paul McCartney. The track is Something by The Beatles. And this, for me, this is a little controversial as well because this is such a great bass line. I've not really listened to the bass tone too much, but I love the track. So let's jump in. Love that bit. Objectively, like, it's just super old school sounding. Is it a bad bass tone? Not. Okay, so if I walked into a bass shop and somebody's playing there with that tone, I might think it's pretty crap. You know, they're not going to be sort of like ripping out any Marcus Miller lines. I'm on the fence. Let me know in the comments. So next up is a name that I never thought I'd be mentioning on a list like this. It is the legendary, the one and only James Jameson. The track is What's Going On. Let's take a listen to the original.
Mother, mother, there's too many of you crying.
It's the best bass tone I've ever heard for this, in this song. I mean, it's just, absolutely love it. P bass, flat wound, not recording the V15, it's actually an Acme DI. As a solo bass tone, maybe not. Okay. I understand where you guys are coming from with this, but I don't know if I can agree with you wholeheartedly. It's James Jameson. So next up was another huge shock to me, Jaco Pastorius. Liberty City on the Word of Mouth album. So we're going to listen to the original and then I'll give you my opinion. Let's jump in. That's one of the coolest fretless sounds of all time. What are you guys thinking? Are your ears drawn on? No, I'm not having it. I disagree with everybody who thinks this is a crap sound. It's amazing. So next up is John Entwistle. The track is The Real Me. The band, obviously, The Who. So let's listen to the original and see what we think.
I went back to the doctor.
Oh, dig it. It's a bit of a gnarly bass tone, isn't it? Yeah, pretty gnarly. I just think I don't like the mix. It could be, better. So next up, and this was really popular, I would say. Number one was the Jason Newsted thing. Second was this. Okay, so it's Fieldy's bass tone on all of the Korn stuff by the sounds of it. You guys just don't like his bass tone, okay? So I've picked Freak on a Leash because it's obviously a super popular track. We'll listen to that and then we're going to listen to the isolated bass track. I kind of like that. There's not much note behind it, obviously. It's more percussive than anything, isn't it? Got it. Okay, yeah, you can hardly hear what note it is. I get where you guys are coming from. Loads of bottom end, strange top end, no middle at all. No notes, just like. Oh, one good note there. Now, finally, we've got a second appearance by the one and only Flea. And this, a ton of you voted for Flea and this specific video as well. I've heard it before. It's been a while since I've watched it, but let's check it out. And again, in the comments, let me know if you agree, disagree, and all of that good stuff. Yeah, I really don't like that bass tone. Sorry, Flea, you're an awesome player, but I don't like that bass tone. So guys, let me know what you think. Do you agree, disagree with the bass tones on this list? Should they be on there? Shouldn't they be on there? And did we miss any off, you know, that should have been on there? Let me know in the comments below. The thing that I came away with after watching all of these videos and listening to them, checking them out, is that in for the most part, I actually think even when it's a really crappy bass tone, in the right context, in the right mix, it can really bring the track alive. So I think it's a lot, there's a lot of art behind it, right? It's sort of like, yeah, objectively on its own, it sounds a bit crappy, but in the mix of the song, it can actually give the song a real vibe, a real kind of just individuality that it wouldn't have without that bass tone. So I think a lot of the time, it depends. Anyway, guys, let me know in the comments your thoughts on this. And as always, take it easy and I'll see you in the shed.